Queen Elizabeth II was reportedly in tears over a feud that had been the cause of division within the royal family for almost a decade, and Prince Philip's behavior towards Her Majesty on the subject was dubbed almost brutal by former Prime Minister Harold Macmillan, a biography claims. The Duke of Edinburgh, a former commander in the Royal Navy, married Queen Elizabeth II on November 20, 1947, and moved into Buckingham Palace. After the birth of Prince Charles and Princess Anne in 1948 and 1950 respectively, Prince Philip initially intended to give the royal children his surname, but his determination set him on a collision course with his mother-in-law, the Queen Mother, and his wife, the Queen. Prince Philip's desire to name his children Mountbatten sparked a lengthy family feud, as his wishes were shot down when former Prime Minister Winston Churchill, Queen Mary and the Queen Mother all decided no, this is not going to be the way. This was confirmed when the Queen issued a public declaration on April 9, 1952, that her children will be styled and known as the House and Family of Windsor prior to her coronation on June 2, 1953. According to reports at the time, that hurt Prince Philip deeply, as he felt like just a bloody amoeba within the royal household, leading to a feud that lasted for almost a decade. He refused to let the matter drop, and when the Queen was pregnant with Prince Andrew in 1960, she told then Prime Minister Harold Macmillan that she absolutely needed to revisit the issue of the family name because it had been irritating her husband since 1952. In the biography, Ms. Bedell Smith cited an entry in Mr. Macmillan's diary, in which he wrote, "The Queen only wishes to do something to please her husband, with whom she is desperately in love. What upsets me is the Prince's almost brutal attitude to the Queen over all this. I shall never forget what she said to me that Sunday night at Sandringham." Mr. Macmillan passed the problem on to his deputy, Rab Butler, and the Lord Chancellor Lord Kilmure. Mr. Butler told Macmillan in a telegram that the Queen had absolutely set her heart on making a change for the Duke's sake. On February 8, 1960, 11 days before the birth of Prince Andrew, a compromise was reached as the Queen made a new declaration in Privy Council saying that she had adopted Mountbatten Windsor as the name for all her descendants who do not enjoy the title of His or Her Royal Highness. The surname first appeared on an official document on November 14, 1973, when Princess Anne chose to sign marital documents with Mountbatten Windsor when she wed Captain Mark Phillips at Westminster Abbey.